Hello, my name is Sebbi, and welcome back to the Coffee Break in Minecraft. Today is Sunday, July 31st, 2016. Oh dear, what is going on down there? That's crazy. So many angry guys were waiting for me, and there's still a creeper left. That's quite concerning. But as long as there is only one creeper, I think I can deal with this green and explosive creature. I have 7 arrows left, so I can now defuse this creeper. Alright, perfect. Are we safe again? Yes, we are safe again. Alright, this is good. Well, of course, there is still the spider, but as long as it's daytime, the spider won't do anything. And so, I can ignore him, but here, this was really a disturbing view out of my window as I saw all those angry creatures waiting for me. And yeah, okay, we are safe again, and I am really surprised that it's once again the end of yet another month of 2016. How has this happened? July 31st. It feels as if it was just July 1st, I went to bed, and someone just changed the date or so, and as I woke up in the morning, yeah, suddenly July 31st. That's crazy, this is really crazy. But yeah, when I look at all the episodes of the Coffee Break I have created, then yeah, it's apparently reality that we are once again at the end of yet another month of 2016, and this is really crazy. What is going on with the passage of time? Sure, time flies when you're having fun, but had we really so much fun that yeah, it's suddenly July 31st? I am so surprised. I can't believe it. And that's crazy. On the other hand, I recently realized that I have achieved one of my main goals for my YouTube channel for this year, because one of my goals was to get into collaborative videos. And here I joined the Salty Dog server, I joined the Conelanders League, and now I'm part of two groups that create collaborative video content, and that's really fantastic. This is really a lot of fun, and yeah, I'm really enjoying this. I'm so happy that everything worked out so well. And well, of course, the Conelanders League isn't so much of a collaborative environment. I mean, we play racing games, so the main goal is to have the best possible outcome, to overtake other drivers, and yeah, so it's everything but a collaborative environment. But on the other hand, our main goal is to release exciting videos of our races, and yeah, so we publish all of our videos at the exact same time so that our viewers can enjoy the races from all the different perspectives, and that's really cool. So in the end, it's a collaborative environment. That's really cool. Of course, there are also some drivers who are more into the whole competition, who really care about the points, the standings in the championship and winning races. But yeah, this is really cool that we can make this work, although we have so many different backgrounds, so many different skills, so many different personal goals. But still, it's working out, and this is really cool. This is so much fun. The same thing also applies to the Salty Dog server. I mean, as you can see, I'm not so much a huge builder. Well, of course, I try to build some smaller projects, like now my park career or the airport. But when I compare this to Mudbucket's projects, because yeah, Mudbucket is building gigantic farms, like the Guardian farm or so. This is really insane. And so we all have different goals, but still we managed to work together and to achieve something. And sure, so far we haven't really created videos together. I mean, I was running around on the Salty Dog server. I showcased some of the the things others have built, I showcased my builds, and I came up with the idea of the Evil Force that was incorporated by other players in their videos, and that's really cool. So to some degree we are making some collaborative videos, and that's really cool. So I really enjoy this. And well, initially as I thought about, yeah, I really like to get into collaborative video content, I thought about, well, we could maybe have some kind of Minecraft CTM map playthrough, so that we try to complete the monument in a collaborative way or so, or that we play Minecraft Bingo. Well, Minecraft Bingo is once again not so much of a collaborative environment, it's more about finishing the Minecraft Bingo card before all the other players are able to do so. But still, those were my initial thoughts when I came up with the idea that I really like to get into the collaborative video creation. But yeah, I'm so happy how everything has turned out, and I'm also so thankful that Lee, the first gen gamer, and Coon Dodger are organizing all of this, because this is really a lot of work. And now I like to try out this daylight sensor idea. I have some nether quartz, I have some wood, but I need glass. I think I have glass in my mountain home. So, Horace, we can now travel to the mountain home. And yeah, so I'm really thankful that Cone Dodger is organizing the Cone Landers League, is putting together the Dirt Rally League, the Assetto Corsa League, and this, of course, takes so much time. It requires so much work, and he does all of this, and I'm really thankful. The same thing, of course, applies to Lee. He is hosting the Minecraft server, the Salty Dog server, and he's constantly adding new exciting mechanics and scripts and things. So this is really cool, and I'm so happy that those two guys are putting all of this together. So yeah, thank you in your direction. Also, I like to thank you. Well, I like to thank all of the members of the Cone Landers and Salty Dog groups, because I'm really happy that I was able to make friends with you, and it's so fantastic having met 25 Rebel, Weekend Game, Mudbucket, First and Gamer, Cone Dodger, and yeah, all the other guys. I think it's better to stop here and to just say I'm so happy that I met all of you who are now part of the Cone Landers League and the Salty Dog server, because in the end I forget to mention someone, and then I feel really, really bad when I edit this video and I realize, okay, I completely forgot to mention this fantastic person, and then I feel bad. And so yeah, all of you, I'm really thankful that I was able to meet you, that we became friends, that we watch our videos, that we comment on our videos, that we discuss things, and well, this means so much to me. I'm really happy how everything has turned out so far in 2016, at least concerning my YouTube channel. I mean, we have, okay, some glass, and I have some slabs. This is coming handy, because I need slabs for the sensors. And can I take something else with me? I don't think so. And well, it's the mountain home isn't so far away from my tower, so it's pretty simple to just travel over here and get some more resources in whenever I really need them. But yeah, so I'm really thankful that I met you. Of course, I'm also thankful for all my other viewers who are enjoying the coffee break, who are enjoying all my other Let's Play videos, like Nexus, Mathieu. That's so fantastic. And yeah, once again, I'm really having a hard time. Q, yeah, I don't have to forget, Q is also an important member. So Yeah, I'm really happy that I met all of you, and if I accidentally haven't mentioned your name, I'm really sorry, but yeah, it's so hard to come up with all the names on the fly. So yeah, in general, all the members of the Conelanders League, all the members of the Salty Dog server, all my viewers, thank you so much for your support, thank you so much for sticking with me, thank you for becoming my friends. I'm really happy. I'm so happy about this. And yeah, so much about this. I just wanted to point out that I achieved this important goal, and I'm so happy about this achievement. And yeah, as the sun is about to set, I have to make an important announcement, as I will be traveling again. If all goes well, I will be already en route to Norway when this episode of the Coffee Break goes live. So I will be once again traveling to to the north. And well, not only I will traveling to the north. North is really the main goal, as we want to travel to the northern regions of Norway, and depending on our depending on our endurance, depending on the weather, we even want to reach the North Cape, which would be really fantastic. Okay, this is now a historic moment. This is the first daylight sensor I ever crafted in Minecraft. So this was an historic moment. This is crazy. The first daylight sensor I've ever crafted. And now I need some redstone and glowstone. Okay, so let's put it there, redstone lamp. And now I need something, I think I can get away with the dirt too. Yeah, okay, it's nighttime. I just like to give it a quick test. I hope there are no evil guys. Okay, let's see, I like to have it maybe here. Yeah, let's have it here. So then redstone, good. And the sensor. Huh. This is... Oh wait, I think I need to turn it into an inverted daylight sensor. Haha! Okay! Here, this is exactly what I wanted to have. Cool. Well, of course I need to replace the dirt at some point. But cool, it's working, it's working. This is fantastic, this is great. So let's... Dang it. Let me in here. And... Cool. Cool, okay, I can illuminate my park area with some lanterns. Oh, that's fantastic. And okay, now it's time to go to bed. So, as I said, I will be traveling. The goal is north. And it would be so cool to reach the North Cape and to, yeah, realize, okay, from this point on, there is just water, and then there is the Arctic. And this is really crazy. Moreover, the North Cape is really high up on the northern hemisphere. At if we would be at this position in the southern hemisphere, we would be in the permanent ice of Antarctica. So this is really crazy how the Gulf Stream is really changing the climate and is increasing the overall temperature at this region. So that's crazy. And yeah, maybe we can even get to the North Cape, which would be really interesting. And so the goal is northern Norway. This should be interesting. And okay, now I have my daylight sensor, and what do I like to do now? I'm still not sure what material I like to use. Maybe I will use some fences. Yeah, maybe I will use some fences below that. This could be interesting. I'm still not sure what material I like to use in order to connect this vantage point. That's a really cool vantage point with the pass around the fountain. I'm not quite sure. Yeah, all the materials I've tried so far weren't looking that great, and red and white isn't working either, so... This is really... glass? And something below that glass? Hmm. Hmm. This might be interesting. Maybe something beneath the glass and glass here. Okay, I have to think about this. But okay, I like to try out the fence idea. And Google is north. So what else? Oh yeah, because I will be traveling, there will be no coffee break episodes for the next few weeks, because yeah, the coffee break is my vlog type situation. So I record the coffee break episodes basically the same day it gets, they get released, and so yeah, it's quite obvious that I can't continue the coffee breaks while I'm traveling. But as soon as I'm okay, this could be interesting. This is good. I like this. This is adding some nice details to the park area. Okay, cool. I like it. Now I'll need some more daylight sensors, and so I need some more quartz, and this means I have to return to the dangerous nether. Let's do this. There will be no coffee breaks, and also there will be no Codelanders content for the time I'm away, because yeah, it's quite obvious when I'm traveling I can't participate in the Etc. Cruiser races. I can't participate in the Dirt Rally events, which is really sad. It would be really nice if we would go back to the monthly format, because then I can catch up with, well, with the progress. But with the weekly format, well, I will miss at least 2 weeks. And yeah, so that's a little bit sad, because, well, as I talked about this at the start of the episode, I really enjoy playing together with those guys. I'm so happy being part of those groups, and yeah, no, it's really sad that I can't continue racing, and this is really a thing I enjoy so much right now. But on the other hand, traveling and having a real world adventure is obviously way more interesting than having yet another race in a virtual racing simulation. So yeah, I mean, it's quite obvious that I prefer to travel to Norway, and to go on an adventure heading north is always cool. So yeah. But I hope you will all miss me, and you will all look forward to my return, and you will all look forward to the stories I have to tell once I am back from this journey. And speaking of these stories, as you know, you can ask questions. I will try my very best to answer your questions. So please keep your questions coming. Please continue to ask me some questions while I'm away. I'm already looking forward to answer them, and you can also ask some questions about Norway or about my journey or so, before I'm even back home. I mean, of course, once I'm back here, I will at first, as I did this with the Iceland journey, talk about or give you an overview of what happened. But when you have some questions, maybe I can answer those questions right away during my report or so. And here, this is coming up. Then, of course, I will take my camera with me again. So I will also, hopefully, create some videos of the journey to Norway, which will be then published on my vlog channel. So yeah, if you have missed those, the Iceland travelog, you can check it out on my vlog channel while I'm away. And yeah, if you miss me too much, you can join me on or follow me on Twitter, because I also like to or I hope I can post some pictures I take on during the journey on Twitter to to show you a little bit what is going on. So yeah, there's a lot of... Okay, now I'm encumbered. This is... can I... I guess I don't need the seats, so have fun with that. Yeah, so there is a lot of Sebbi content, and if you... Yeah, you can also go back into the history of the coffee break and watch previous episodes or so. So there is plenty of stuff. Also, I have prepared several videos for the time I'm away. Of course, the schedule is a little bit thinned out, so I think there will be only 4 videos per week instead of a video per day. So, but on the other hand, there will be some interesting stuff for you, and yeah, I really hope you will enjoy what I have prepared for you, and yeah, then I hope you're looking forward to my return, and as I said, I hope you will miss me and leave comments, and yeah, I think that's all I wanted to say. So we have some... Oh no, dang it, okay, I don't need eggs. I hope you... No, yeah, I think that's all I wanted to say. We have some time left, a few minutes left, so I think I can answer Weekend Games' last question. Weekend Game is a really curious guy, and yeah, Weekend Game, I know you can come up with creative questions, and this is the last question. I hope you can come up with some more questions while I'm away, so that I have more things to talk about when I'm back. And yeah, his last question is... I have also heard that German companies can dub over foreign films with great skill, such that the viewer can't always tell the movie wasn't originally filmed in German. If so, do you prefer to watch movies in German or in English if that was the original language? Well, I would definitely recommend that you go back into the history of the coffee breaks, because I talked about this several times already, and yeah, it's true that all the movies are dubbed, and that's... I think this is also the reason why so many Germans have issues with the English language, as... yeah, when I travel to other countries, that, well, they often have only the English language, and they just have some subtitles or so, and those people over there have no issues with English, and they have a pretty good English, they have no issues understanding English. But over here in Germany, most people have some issues with English, and I think this is also a result of, well, all the movies being dubbed to German. And yeah, moreover, I find it pretty annoying, as sometimes they did a good job, and it's okay, the movie is still as good as in English, but sometimes you have some... Yeah, it really depends on the content, it depends on the dialogues, but sometimes when you translate something from English to German or so, you lose something because of the structure of the language, and maybe because the words aren't as ideal as they are in the other language. So this is all the time problematic, and in this case, if possible, I prefer watching the original movies. And well, this is of course a huge problem over here, as yeah, when everything gets dubbed to German, then how can I watch something in the original language? Of course, sometimes my movie theater features some original movies. I think they do this because we have... Well, it's a small town, we have a large university, and so there are plenty of foreign students, and maybe that's the reason why it pays off for the movie theater to feature original movies. And then, of course, I go into this movie instead of the German version. But in general, all the stuff that is running on TV is dubbed, and yeah, so if I really want to, or if I really enjoy a series, I have to watch it in English. The best example is Game of Thrones. I accidentally watched an episode in German, and it was horrible because I was used to the perfect and ideal and great language of in Game of Thrones. Moreover, the English language has so many different accents, and this is also a thing you can't really bring to German, especially when they have those dialogues between Americans and British people. And yeah, the British accent is of course different to the American accent, and this isn't working in German, because you can't really translate this, but you can't really come up suddenly with different German accents. Like, okay, the British people have a Bavarian accent, and the American people have an North German accent or so. No, this isn't working out. So those are also some issues. And in this case, yeah, I try to watch everything in English if possible, but that's not easy, as everything that runs on TV is dubbed, so I have to get my hands on those things via other means. And that's not always the ideal way. So in this case, everything over here is dubbed to German. It's not my cup of tea. It's pretty bad, but there's nothing I can do about it. I wish there would be some alternative so that I can enjoy movies in their original language in a simpler way, but I don't think that this is that easy to implement over here. And but to answer your question, I prefer watching it in English. And with this, we are now at the end of this episode. I hope you have enjoyed it. I hope you will have a fantastic summer. I hope you will enjoy what I have prepared for you. If you miss me, you can follow me on Twitter, and you can go back into the history of the coffee breaks or into the history of my YouTube channel if it's not enough what I have prepared for you. And you can also enjoy the Iceland travelogue on my vlog channel. And here, there is plenty of stuff you can enjoy while I'm away, and I hope I will see all of you again once I'm back. Until then, my name is Sebbi. See you!